In this second part of lesson 8, we will look at another very interesting problem in which we try to find if an array has a majority element. So imagine that we are given an array A of n, let's think of them as votes, right? We define that this array has a majority element if there is an element, let's say V, that appears at least n over 2 times plus 1. So, for instance, if I give you this array, the element B appears 4 times, but it's not a majority element because n is equal to 8, and so B does not appear at least 5 times. On the other hand, if the array was this one, then it would be that B is a majority element. So the problem that we have to solve is first to ask whether there is a majority element in the given array, and if there is, to actually identify it. I want to say from the beginning that we're looking for just to identify the majority element. We don't want to just go through the array and count how many votes each of these candidates gets. Imagine that we don't have the space to keep track of all the candidates. And the other thing I want to clarify here is that the only operation we are allowed to do is to compare two votes, whether they are the same or whether they are different. We're not allowed to ask whether one vote is larger or smaller than another. So let's see how we can solve this problem using divide and conquer with an algorithm that is big O n log n. Imagine that we have an array A with n elements. As we usually do with divide and conquer, we think how to split this problem into smaller subproblems that we can solve recursively. So imagine that we split the array A, AL for left and AR for right. If the original array has n elements, these two arrays have n over 2 elements. I'm just assuming here that n is even to keep things simple. The idea, of course, would be that trying to find if A has a majority element, we recursively try to find if AL and AR have a majority element, and then we try to combine somehow the solution into the solution of the initial problem. So we need to understand more what happens with respect to the majority element of A, of AL, and of AR. If the initial array A has a majority element, let's say V, then it must be that AL or AR, or both of them, have a majority element which is also V. Why is this true? Suppose that V appears in A n A times, and suppose that it appears in AL n L times and in AR n R times. If V is a majority element, then we must have that NA is greater or equal than n over 2 plus 1. If we assume here that V is not the majority element of neither AL nor AR, then it has to be that NL is smaller or equal than N over 4, and NR is smaller or equal than N over 4 again. If we add these two things, we get that NL plus NR is smaller or equal than N over 2. But NL plus NR is nothing but NA. So we are left here with a contradiction. The second note that I want to see here is that it may be that the original array A does not have a majority element, but at least one of these two arrays have a majority element. Here is an example that would clearly illustrate that. As you see, in the original array, we don't have a majority element. Neither of these two things appears at least n over 2 plus 1 times. But when we split the input into these two subarrays, in this one the majority element is B, in this one the majority element is C. So what this means is that if we try to solve this problem recursively, and the solution for this array is that yes, there is a majority element, we cannot assume that that majority element is also the majority element of the initial array. We have to check whether the majority element of AL or the majority element of AR, whether it is actually a majority element also of A. How long would it take? Imagine that AL, for example, has a majority element called VL. Then we have to go through the array A, counting how many times we see VL. If VL does not appear at least n over 2 plus 1 times, then it's not a majority element of A. And we may need to do the same thing also for the majority element of AR. So if we put all of these things together, we understand that the time it would take to solve this problem recursively for an input of size n, plus linear time to check whether the majority element of either AL or AR, majority element of A. If neither AL nor AR have a majority element, then we can be certain that A does not have a majority element either based on this point. Of course, you have seen this recursion before. It's also the recursion of merge sort, and you know by now that T of n in this case is big O n log n. Can we solve this problem, however, in a faster way than big O n log n? So here is a linear time solution, again, divide and conquer, for the majority problem. We're trying to go from an array of size n to a smaller problem of at most n over 2 elements. So one way we can do this is by considering pairs of elements of A. They don't have to be successive elements, but I will here draw them as successive. And we consider these n over 2 pairs. If in a certain pair we have two different elements, let's say u and v, we ignore these two elements from the array A prime. We don't include neither u nor v in A prime. On the other hand, if there is a pair in which we have the same element, let's say v, in both positions, then we keep one of these two v's in the array A prime. So if we had the example uv, array A prime would be an array with only two elements. In the worst case scenario, A prime will have n over 2 elements if each of these pairs consists of an identical element. For example, if we had... I hope you understand that through this process we go from a problem of size n to a problem of size at most n over 2 that we can try to solve recursively. So let's try to understand again the relation between the majority element of A, if it exists, and the majority element of A prime, if it exists. The first point I want us to see is that, again, if A has a majority element, let's say V, then V must also be a majority element of this reduced array A prime, based on how we constructed A prime. Suppose that V is the most frequent element of A and it appears n v times, and let's say u is the item with the second higher frequency and it appears n u times. In the worst case, you may think that n v is n over 2 plus 1 and n u is n over 2 minus 1, so there is no other element. N v appears the least number of times so that it is a majority element, and all the other votes go for u. Even in this worst case scenario, the number of instances of v in A prime will be one more, at least one more, than the number of instances of u. The second point I want us to see is that if A does not have a majority element, it is still possible that A prime has a majority element. So, as in the previous case, we need to check whether the majority element of A prime is also the majority element of A. An illustration of this would be this array A, which doesn't have a majority element, but after we do the pairing, we reduce A to A prime, and as you see here, A prime has a majority element. So we need to check if the majority element of A prime is actually a majority element of A. Let's see what is the resulting recursion. We start with a problem of size n, and we reduce it to only one problem of size at most n over 2. And after we solve this problem, we have to check in linear time whether the majority element of A prime, if it exists, it's actually the majority element of A as well. So this is our recursion. If you go back to the master theorem, we have alpha equal to 1, beta equal to 2, which means that the log base beta of alpha is 0, while gamma, this exponent here, is 1. So according to the master theorem, we have that the running time here is big O n to the power gamma, which in this case is... So this is actually a case of the master theorem. If you go back to your notes from lesson 7, this is the case that gamma is larger than the log base beta of alpha. And as we see in this case, binding essentially the solutions is the dominant term in the running time of the recursive algorithm.